Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, we'll be doing this Photoshop Elements glass ornament. And this is made from just a few different layers up here. Pretty straightforward, pretty simple to do. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to share, and also don't forget to subscribe as well. I do several videos every single week, about half of those on Photoshop Elements. You can find out more about that on my channel. Also, take a look at my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. All right, here's our basic ornament picture. And across the bottom down here, you'll see the photos that I used for this. The left side with the ornaments here, this is just that top right there. It's all that is. That's just the background. There's a gingerbread house inside, and there are two soap bubbles, which I combined together to make this main glass effect. Okay, let's get rid of this. Just cancel that out. There we go. And we'll start off with this file right here as our main working file. Now, if you want to work along with this project, you can download these files, including the finished file as well, from my website. There's a link for that in the description. Okay, we'll start off with this file right here. Now, I want to make a layer mask on this one, blocking off everything except for just the soap bubble. So let's have our rulers up. If you don't see your rulers, go up to View, come down to and check Rulers right there. And then just pull down a little guideline right here and pull it right to the edge of that soap bubble. Do the same thing on the left-hand side, right to the edge, just like that right there. And right-hand side, same thing, and then at the bottom, right down there. Doesn't need to be absolutely perfect, but try to get it as close as you can on this. Now we'll use these guides to make a selection and use that selection to make a layer mask. To make this easy, you want to have Snap To Guides selected. Go up here to View, come down to Snap To, and make sure that Guides is checked. It should be by default. Okay, so now grab the elliptical marquee tool. If you don't see that, if you see the square one up here, rectangular one, just come down to the options and click on the elliptical. Set your feathering at 0. That's very important on this. You have a feathering of 0. Come right on the top up here, upper left-hand corner where those two lines cross. On top of that, click and drag from there down to the bottom right corner. When you're right over the top there, the circle should snap right to those guidelines. There's our selection. That's all done. Now let's make a copy of our background layer here. So where it says background, right click, duplicate layer, choose OK. You can now hide that background. And then up here, click on this, add layer mask. And there it is. There's our soap bubble nicely masked out from the background. Nice transparent background. Let's now bring in our second image right down here. Easy way to do this is if you have floating windows like this, just go over here, grab the background, and drag it on. If you don't have floating windows, let's say you have your windows docked like that, you can still do this. Just be on your first tab, take this here and just drag it on top like that. It does exactly the same thing. Now on this one, notice how it's smaller than our previous bubble, so I have to make this larger, and to do that, we'll have to move back a little bit. So I'll go to my zoom tool here, and let's zoom out a little bit, kind of like that, back to the move tool again. Now have your control handles in the corners and on the sides. Come out to one of the corners. I'll use the bottom right corner and then pull this down to a little bit past like that. It'll come back in again. Don't worry about that. Go to the upper left-hand corner and pull that up. And then let's go over here to the upper right-hand corner. Pull that up a little bit. And just kind of pull your corners out until that soap bubble is fitting inside of those guidelines nicely. And it's just about there. That's pretty good. And then click on the green check mark for OK. Now all we need to do is to come in and do the same layer mask on this. So come down to our layer mask right here. Look for your light blue outline. Make sure you see that. Click on that side to see that. Hold the Alt key down. Pull it straight up. That then copies this layer mask up to here. We now have our two soap bubbles, one on top of the other. We now need to blend these together. So go to your top layer. And on your top layer, we're going to be changing this blend mode up here to linear dodge. There you go. Come down to the bottom one, and we'll change our blend mode down here to hard light. You'll be seeing this in just a bit. You can't see it right now, But you'll see it once we add in some more stuff in here. Okay, now go back to your top layer, and let's go back to the photo bin, and we'll bring up the gingerbread house right here. If you don't have floating windows and you want to do that, just go up here to the Edit menu, come down to Preferences and General, and make sure that that checkbox right there, Allow Floating Documents in Expert Mode, is checked. Then you'll have your floating windows. Okay, let's grab that background, drag it over here. There's our gingerbread house. Let's just get that out of the way now. Now I need to bring this down in size. Same thing. So again, go to your corners and pull down on the corners until it begins to fit inside. And that's pretty close right there. Just click the green check mark. There it is. Take this layer, pull this one down to the bottom of your stack, just above our hidden background layer, and you should see it inside. Now if it's in behind and you go to move it and you accidentally move one of your soap bubbles, first make sure that your layer is selected and then come down here to your options and make sure that auto select layer is not checked. Very important. If that's checked, it'll grab your top layer. So make sure that's unchecked. You can then come in here and move this around. It's a little bit too large still. Notice how it's kind of snapping to our lines right now. So the snap to lines is causing us a problem at this point. So go up to view, come down to snap to uncheck guides, and I'll go ahead and hide the guides as well. And now that shouldn't be an issue. I'll put it right about there. It's just where that left side is kind of bumping up against that edge and the right side as well. So it just kind of fits right in there in the base. Okay, let's now hide those soap bubbles. Let's zoom in on this and let's clean that background up. Come down to your magic wand right here. Make sure to set it new to start off with. I have my tolerance at 32, that's the default. Then just click outside here someplace. And it looks like that just about grabbed the whole thing. Come down and switch your mode here to add. And then there's a little bit right here I need to grab. I'll just click on that. That's good. And right down here, this kind of a reflection, I'll grab that one. And there we go. I now have the whole back area selected. Let's now invert that selection. Go up to Select, come down to Inverse, and now just the house is selected. And then click on the Layer Mask button, and you should now see that, just nothing but the house. Okay, let's go ahead and bring back our soap bubbles. There's the house inside of our bubbles. Okay, now we can go back to Fit on Screen, just like that. Come back down to the background layer down here. We'll go back to the photo bin, and I'll bring up this picture here. This is our background picture. Just drag that one in. Then you can place this where you like. I don't like it where this branch is right against the soap bubble effect here, so bring that down a little ways. And you'll need to size this up probably kind of like that, so you have a nice little bit of floating greenery in there. I think that looks pretty good right about there. Okay, so far so good. Now on the soap bubbles, a little bit of a line right here. I don't really like that. I'm seeing the kind of a thin outer line. That's the background soap bubble, and this bright white, that's the foreground. Kind of see if I do that, that's our foreground. So foreground's not quite in the right spot. So just click on that, and then I'll use the arrow keys. I'm just going to move it up and over a little bit, and maybe it's just a little bit too small. So to fix that, I'm going to back out just a little bit here. Use my zoom, and let's just back out like that. The reason I'm zooming out is because if we select that, you can see out here, there's the actual size of that image. It's way out here. And I'll grab this upper right-hand corner and pull it up just a little bit, and the bottom down just a little bit. And I think that'll fit better. That looks good. Okay. And now I can go ahead and zoom back into fit screen. That's better. Just kind of cleaned up that edge a little bit. Now we need our top part up here. And we'll just steal that from another picture. And let's bring up this file. There we are. Now all we need in here is just this bit and just a little bit of the string right there. So I'll zoom in on that. And it's just a little bit out of focus as well. Let's go ahead and fix that focus first. Go up to Enhance, come down to Adjust Sharpness. I have mine at the default amount, so that looked pretty good. Actually, there's the before, there's the after. It's a real small amount, but just a touch. Choose OK. All right, now this is the trickiest part of the whole process, actually, is just this bit right here. We need to make a selection around this. We'll copy this from this file and then paste it into our other file. So I'll just use the polygonal lasso tool, and that's the one right down there. And I'll start right here at this corner. Now on this, just take your time. If you click too fast with the polygonal lasso tool, it's going to collapse your selection and you have to start over again, so you don't want to do that. And on these curves, just come around, just do just several small clicks. Now it's going to be a very, very small in the picture, so it's really not going to be that critical. We're really working kind of on a micro level at this point. So it doesn't need to be super, super accurate, but try to get it as good as you can. Just take your time with this tool and work around and make your selection, just like I'm doing right now. Now, since this will take me a couple of minutes to do, I'm just going to fast forward the video at this point to go ahead and finish this up. And as soon as it fast forward is done, then I'll slow the things down and we'll finish this up at that point. Okay, there's our outside selection. We now need to remove this bit from inside of our selection. So we're on our subtract tool right there. And then we'll start right here. And I'll just work this around and get this inside bit out of here. This goes actually pretty fast on this. Just work on the inside. Take this out, and we're then ready to go ahead and copy this out over to the other file. And once that's done, we're just about done with the picture. Actually, it goes pretty fast at this point. The hardest part of the whole project really is just doing this selection. Okay, that's been removed. Now go up to Edit, come down to Copy. I'll just minimize that. And I want to be on the top layer up here. And then Edit and Paste. And there it is sitting on top of everything else. I'll just move this up here to the top, just like that. Just kind of position that. You can move it around if you want to with your cursor keys, the arrow keys, until it looks good. And I think that's pretty nice right there. And I think I'm going to take this layer, hold the control key down, and grab all of the ornament layers right here. And I'll bring everything down a little bit with my arrow keys on the keypad, just until I see a little bit of that thread showing at the top. It just makes it look a bit more realistic right there. Okay, there we go. And right about there, looks good. And that's it. So that's how to make a glass ornament here using just two soap bubble pictures and a couple of blend mode tricks. And don't forget, if you had fun doing this project, click on that like button. Also click on that share button and share with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe. Again, I do a bunch of videos every single week. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. And there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, I'll see you next time.